Of all the competency models reviewed and the reading, and after giving it much thought, I would say the SHRM competency model is the most relevant for my particular industry. I work for the City of Detroit, my local government, which is in the public sector. Because we serve and provide service to the public, we are expected to possess leadership, business, and interpersonal competencies. Regardless of our titles, we are expected to perform in leadership roles, and whether we are interacting with our internal or external customers, we must also always act in an ethical manner. We have laws that govern our daily practice from the federal, state, and local level that we must adhere to. In the public sector, local government officials must be proficient in business to succeed through identifying, designing, implementing, and evaluating talent management and other business solutions to meet not only the needs of the organization, but businesses who operate within the city and the residents of the city. Interpersonal competencies are important in every organization, but are even significantly greater to our organization because relationship management, global and cultural effectiveness, and communication is necessary to help all departments work together more effectively. Since leaders are not solely made in classrooms, according to one of this week's chapters, my personal approach to continue to develop appropriate competencies on my leadership journey is to learn by observation. I will continue to learn the laws that govern our organization and look for ways to function more efficiently and effectively. I will model my leadership qualities from some of the greatest leaders of our time, from the people who are natural born leaders, but not in the leadership role, and I will listen to what the internal and external customers want in a leader. I personally do not think a person can lead without listening and finding out what the people want in a leader. A good leader is a great listener.